is here in this group?
So me and Abhiru.
Okay, Chandrakant, then send a message in your group to attend, to join everyone.
Yes, sir, I have already sent it. Just give me a few minutes.
Okay, in the meantime, do you have any doubt regarding function? How you have to define a function and how to call this function?
No, sir.
Okay. So, let us discuss some topic like different types of variables. And we have used only integer data type till now, but we need to discuss some more data types so that you can write any program. Okay, so I'm coming to that, just a minute. So this is the different data type. So we can classify the data types as integer data type and floating point data type. So on these data types, for integer and floating point numbers, we can perform arithmetic operation. Okay. Beyond that, we have some enumerated data type. We will discuss it in last few classes. So this data type is generally used for creating a variable like Boolean, as Boolean is not supported in C programming language. So we can customize this data type. So we can create some enum data type and we can use it. One data type we have discussed in the last class, just we have mentioned that when a function is returning a value, the corresponding data type is being written as the return type of the function. Sometimes we are writing that the return type is void. So void means if the return type of a function is void, it indicates that the function will not return any value. Okay. But there are some more use of void. Okay. So we will come to that when we will discuss pointer. And some derived types are there. We have not discussed these things till now. So we have only discussed some basic data types and we have worked with integer type only. Okay. So these are the different data types which are supported in this programming language. So you can see the size of the data type. So character is 1 byte, unsigned character is again 1 byte. So what is signed and what is unsigned? So generally, for a data type, we use the first bit to indicate whether it's a signed value or unsigned value. Okay, so signed and unsigned, when we will discuss the things with respect to bit pattern, then we will discuss the things in detail. So if we consider character, so size of the character is 1 byte. Okay, just give me 1 minute, I will connect the pen. So here, so if we consider signed data type, if we do not mention anything, by default it's a signed data type. So 1 byte means 8 bit. Okay, so if we have 8 bit, then you can understand that what will be the range of this value, 8 bit. So total number of elements can be, how many numbers you can generate using 8 bit? It will be 2 to the power 8. Okay, so if we can generate 2 to the power 8 number of distinct numbers, then if it's a signed, half of these numbers will be negative and rest of the elements will be positive. Okay, so starting from minus 2 to the power 7 up to plus 2 to the power 7, so that will be the range. So starting from 2 to the power minus 2 to the power 7 to up to 2 to the power 7, basically this one will be minus up to this minus 1. Okay, so 2 to the power 7 is 2 to the power 7, this value is 128. Okay, that's why this value is up to 127. Okay, but if it's an unsigned value, if we declare this data type as unsigned, then signed bit will be neglected. So signed bit will be considered as a data. So in that case, starting from 0, it will be up to 255. Okay, so this value is starting from 0 to up to 2 to the power 8 minus 1. This is the range. Okay, in that way, for every data type, the range is mentioned here. Okay, so signed character is 1 byte again. For integer, earlier the system was 2 byte, but now it is on 64-bit architecture, the size of integer is 4 byte. Unsigned int, again it's 4 byte, short is 2 byte, unsigned short is 2 byte, long is 4 byte, and unsigned long is 4 byte. But nowadays I think the long is 8 byte and unsigned long is again 8 byte. Okay, I have not updated this here. So this is the range of different integer data type. Now we have to come to floating point number. Okay, so in case of floating point number, we can store the fractional values. Like if we divide x by y, okay, say x equals to 5 and y equals to 7. So if we divide this number by this, then it will be a floating point number. So it is, so what kind of data type you have to use to store this value? So basically the data type will be a floating point number. Okay, so if we declare this value, like I'm assuming that I'm writing a program where x is, the data type of x is integer, data type of y is again integer. So when I will divide x by y, the value which will be generated, it will not be an integer. It will be a floating point number. So if I want to store it in z, it should be, the data type of z should be a floating point number. Okay, so it will be able to hold the fractional value. Okay, so the size of floating point number is 4 byte. If we use double, it will be 8 byte, and for long double it will be 10 byte. Okay, so in this way we can manage it. So in case of floating point number, how many decimal places it will store? It will store up to 6 decimal places. In case of double, it will be up to 15 decimal places, and it will be up to 19 decimal places. Okay, so according to the requirement, you have to decide that what type of data type you have to use in your program for a variable. Okay, so these are the basic data types which are used in C programming language. Now, this thing I will not discuss here. So we have only discussed this one. Earlier we have discussed this one. So function returns void. We have discussed only this one. So if a function returns void, that means the function will not return any value. Okay, so it will not return any value to the caller. Now we can send some argument as void to a function. Okay, so if we send an argument as void to a function, like I'm writing a function, say the name of this function is fun, and I'm writing its data parameter as void. This function is returning integer. So this one is basically return type. This is the return type of this function, and this one is parameter. Okay, so parameter, if parameter is void, it indicates that this function will never receive any argument. Okay, so this function will not receive any argument. And if the return type of a function is void, like void, the name of this function is fun, so it indicates that the function will not return any value. Okay, later when we will discuss pointer, then we will discuss void pointer. It's a very important data type which is used for memory allocation, and in some other cases this one is used. Okay, we can't discuss the things here. Basically the presentation is prepared for campus interview, not for class directly. Can you see my screen?
No sir, not right now.
No sir.
Just it has closed, I think.
Yes sir.
For some reason. Okay, so
now it's resolved.
Okay. So let us discuss something like how to use this data types. I'm going to create a function. So this is my main function. I will use this is my main function, and in this main function I'm going to declare two variables, x and y, both are integer. Okay, now I want to calculate, basically I want to calculate x by y. So what will be the data type of z?
Float.
So it will be float. So I will declare z as float. So I'm initializing it here. So x equals to say 16 and y equals to say 7. So this value will be calculated, and finally I want to print this value. Here after calculation I will print this value. For printing, I want to print z. We know that we use d for integer values, but if it's a floating point number, then I will use percentile f. Okay, so here I can use z. Okay, so let me save this program. Okay, let me save it somewhere. So this one, I want to run it. What will be the result?
2.00.
Yeah. So the value is 2 point, then some zeros. But actually, what should be the value? It will be 2 point something, but it's not zero. We are dividing 16 by 7. Okay.
If we write 0.2f, then
the voice is not clear. Can you discuss it again?
Sir, if we write after percentage, if we write 0.2f, then it will give the two decimal values after.
If we write 0.2f. Okay. Is it? Hello?
No, sir, it does not give.
No, sir, it's still zero.
Okay. So basically, I'm not going to discuss 0.2f or something point something or x point y here. This is a formatter, nothing else. We'll discuss printf and scanf formatters later. So percentile f is used for floating point number. Okay, now the problem is x is integer, y is again integer. Okay, so if we divide an integer by another integer, then it will be something like that what you have seen. So what we can do, we have to convert it to a floating point number. Okay, now if I save this and I compile this, then you can see that the result is something like this. Okay. Now the result is 2.285714. So how many decimal places is there? 6 decimal places?
Yes, sir.
So we have discussed that for floating point number, this value will be up to 6 decimal places. So here we have mentioned that, yeah, this one up to 6 decimal places if we use it. Okay, now, so what actually happens here? So this is basically known as type casting. This is type casting. We are converting x to floating point number, then we are dividing it by y. Okay, so instead of that, instead of using this, if all the values are floating point numbers, like let me consider that this one is float, whether it will compile? X is 16, y is 7. Okay, so if x and y both are floating point number, when a floating point number is being divided by another floating point number, there is no problem. It will generate a floating point value. Okay, but when x and y both are integer number and x is divided by y, then it will generate, our expected result is a floating point number, but x and y are not floating point number. In that case, it will give us a result which will be truncated after integer value. That's why it will be 2.000, like that. Okay. Now I'm showing you that if x is floating point number and y is integer, what will happen? X is floating point number, but y is integer. If we divide it, the value is same. Okay. Now, if x is integer and integer number is being divided by a floating point number, then what will happen? Then again, this value is this. It's access denied. Okay. Now x is integer and this one is floating point number. Somehow it was locked. Okay. So if any one of them, any one of x and y is a floating point number, then after division, the result will be a floating point number. But if both of them are integer, then it will be truncated after the decimal places. Okay, so it will truncate it after dot. So this is the purpose of typecasting. So if we have integer, if an integer value is being divided by another integer value, the result will be an integer value. Okay, so if we want to force it to, if we want to convert it to floating point number, then any one of this. So I will prefer to convert x to a floating point number, then divide this x by y. So we will get our expected result. Okay, so this is typecasting. So typecasting is mainly used for converting a data type to another data type. Okay. Is it clear? Any doubt? Hello?
Yes, sir, clear.
Okay. Now I will come to let me consider that x is a little bit large number. Okay. Say 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Okay. This is the result. Now. Okay. This one is too large value. I have to check that how long it will be supported. Okay. So if I add some more digit in this number, then it exceeds the value of the range of integer. Okay. So if it exceeds the range of integer, then we can't use it. In that case, we have to use long data type. Okay, so here x is this value. So x is being divided by y. Now, my question is to make it a little bit simple. Let me, how many characters are there? Okay, this one. I'm keeping this one like this. So x is this. Now, I want to store it. Comment these lines. Just a minute. Sanjita. Class Nichi. Bolo. Okay, so just I am closing the other lines. So I am commenting these lines. So I have an integer data type. Okay, so if I want to print this value, just I will keep this one. So I want to print this value. So if I print this value, can I print it using percentile f? X equals to this value when I'm using printf percentile fx, then it becomes 0. Let me run this program. So when I'm using percentile d, this value is this. Okay, the expected output. Now if I use percentile f here, then I'm trying to print a floating point number, so it becomes 0. Okay, so you should be very careful that what kind of data type you are going to print. So based on that, you have to decide that whether it will be percentile D, percentile F, or percentile C, like that. Okay, now the next question is I am going to declare a short data type, say short p. Okay. So if I declare short p and I want to assign the value of x in p, the value of p is being assigned by value of x. Okay, what will happen if I want to print the value of p? Check the output. Now the value of p becomes, just I will add some new line because it is being appended, the message is being appended here. Okay. So the value is -26752. Okay, this is a negative value, but basically this one is not usable. So when we are trying to put a large number in shorter space, size of integer is, we have discussed that size of integer is 4 bytes, whereas what is the size of short? Short is 2 bytes. So if I have a value which is larger than 2 bytes, it cannot be stored in short variable. So when I'm trying to assign the large value, which is x, in a short variable, then some digits are being truncated. So it will not be in decimal form, some bits will be truncated. So after truncating those bits, when it will be allocated in 2 bytes of memory space, then the expected data cannot be achieved. So the data will be lost. Okay. Now if I do the just opposite of this, okay, so I am declaring this variable as short. Okay, just before this, let me take a smaller value like this one. This one can be stored in short. So if I run this program, so 1645, this value will fit in 2 bytes of memory space, so it will work fine. But if the value is exceeding the size of a short data type, then we can't store it there, because in a smaller container you can't put a large item. Okay, so container size should be greater than the size of the data or the item you want to put it here. So is it fine? Now if I just think that this one is short and I want to put it in integer, so p is integer and x is short, it will not compile if I keep this on, because the size of it exceeds the size of short. Okay, so I will try to put a value like this. This one will be able to store it in short. So if I have a short data type, we can easily allocate to a integer value, because the opposite is fine. We have a smaller data which can be kept in a larger container. Okay, so we can keep a small value in large container, so it will not create any problem. Okay, is it fine how we'll
store
this value,
sir?
Yeah,
sir. Now we can change percent d to percent f, will it run, because it falls under floats range.
float. This one is not float.
But we have declared t as integer.
X is short. Short is again an integer data type for storing a smaller value. So short is integer. P is also integer. So we can't use percentile f. Percentile f will be used for floating point number. So here, as both of them are integer, I want to print p. P is integer, so I will use percentile d. Is it fine?
Yes, sir.
Okay, anything, any other query?
No, sir.
Okay, let me comment these lines. And I want to work with character variable. Okay. So say I'm going to declare a variable char c. Okay. What kind of data we can store in a character variable? It will be something like, okay, I want to print this character variable. So here I will use percentile c. So for character variable we have to use percentile c. Now if I print it, then the value of character is being printed. Okay. Now a character variable can be used to hold only one character. You can't write that I will store x, y. Okay. Multiple characters cannot be stored in a character variable. Only one character can be stored in it. Okay. Now, if I use percentile d, whether it will work? C equals to x. Now I want to print c using percentile d. We know that for character data type, we should use percentile c. But if I use percentile d, what will happen?
ASCII code.
So it will print the ASCII code of this character. Okay. So it will print the ASCII code of x. Okay. So to check that what are the ASCII values, we can just run a loop, say, I equals to say 1, I less than 127, I plus plus. I want to print the ASCII values. Okay, so int I am declaring this variable I. Now within this loop I am going to print the character. After some spaces I will print the value. So if I write I, then the value of I, first the value of I will be printed in character form, then the value of I will be printed, the next I will be printed in ASCII form. So if I run this program, you can check the console. It will print the ASCII values starting from 1 to this. Okay. So in book you have seen that there are different ASCII values. So what is the minimum, what is the starting point of A? You know that A is 65. A in uppercase, it will 65. So 97 so Z is 90, And again, small a will start from 97 and it will end at 122. So these are the ASCII values which we are printing. So if we use percentile C, it will print in character form. If we use percentile D, it will print in ASCII value. Okay, so it's a decimal representation of the ASCII value. Okay, any query in this part? Is it clear to you that if we want to print, or if we want to work with different type of data, we can use different data types? Now, if we have a smaller data, that can be easily kept in a larger memory space. But if we have some scenario where a larger value needs to be stored in a smaller value, a smaller memory, then the data will be truncated. Sometimes the data will not be as per our expectation, so it may be lost. Okay. So, and sometimes we have used typecasting, like here we have converted a data type to another data type to get our desired result. So up to this, if you don't have any doubt, then we can move forward. Okay, now I want to show you one more thing. Want to swap two numbers? How do you swap? I have to swap two numbers. Let us consider that I have a variable x and variable y. Current value of x is 10 and current value of y is, say, 7. I have to swap these numbers. Okay, so after swap operation, basically what is expected? Expected value is the value of x will be 7 and y will become 10. So how do you swap these two numbers? I think you have already learned, so you have to answer.
So using temporary or without using temporary? Means using third variable or not using third variable?
Okay, using third variable, it's very easy. But if we do not use third variable, okay, if we do not use third variable,
so, yes sir, so then we just need to add the numbers and then place it, like right here we need to do just x will be x plus y, then y will be x minus y, then x will be again x minus y, like that.
Okay, can I do it using multiplication?
Yes sir.
Okay, but it will create some problem. Do you think that it will create
addition and subtraction will be much easier, I think.
Addition and subtraction. Okay, x equals to x plus y, then?
Then y equal to x minus y, and after that x equal to x minus y.
Minus y. And finally, x equals to?
X minus y.
X minus. let us test. I want to print these values. D percentile D. So I want to print the value of X and Y. That's it. So return. So 7 and 10. Okay. Now, what is the range of X? X is integer. Okay. So if X is integer, 2147482147. Let me consider a very large value. 2147. Okay. And equals to 1. Okay. What will happen? Okay. In case of terminal cases, even it passes. Now, if I take a value like this, okay, so here basically I want to print these values before swapping. I want to print those values and then after swap I will print. Should use new line. Just a minute. You can see that these values are being swapped, but actually the value is being truncated because this data type this one is exceeding the limit of the memory location. So we are allocating a larger value than X and Y. Okay. Here, instead of using plus and that means addition and subtraction operation, if I use multiplication and division operation, what will happen? Because the logic is same, instead of addition and subtraction, if we use multiplication and division, the result should be as per our expectation. But the problem is, in case of division, it generates floating point number. Okay, so if it's a floating point number, some bits or some data is being lost. Okay, a floating point number, if we use floating point data type, then it will hold up to 6 decimal places. So after 6 decimal places, it will be lost. It will be truncated during the calculation when it will be stored in a memory. So it will create a problem. So somewhere, if you have seen that sometime we can use plus minus and multiplication division, obviously you should use plus minus instead of multiplication and division. The another reason is, if we multiply two numbers like this, X is too large, Y is too large. Okay, now if we multiply X by Y, the result will be very, very large number. Okay, so when I'm trying to store it in X, many bits will be lost. Okay, so many bits will be lost. So the actual data will be lost. So when you are applying some logic to calculate something, be very careful that what kind of operation you should use. Okay.
Sir, there will be another error, like if y will be 0, then it will give a runtime error.
Yeah, in case of division.
Yes, sir.
Yeah, we can't divide a number by 0. Okay, so that's all. We are running out of time. Okay, then we will meet on the next class. So today your exam will be taken. Okay. So give this exam in proper time. Okay, fine. So thanks. So I'm closing this meeting.
Thank you, sir.
Okay, bye.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.
Okay. Thanks a lot.
Sir, attendance?
Yeah, the attendance is being automatically saved.
Okay.
With your duration of participation. The everything is being stored in MS Team. Okay. Okay. Bye.